They call this place the Redneck Riviera. But you know what? They don't like that term anymore because it is neither redneck nor Riviera. Welcome to Gulf Shores and Orange Beach, Alabama's own little slice of paradise. I've never been here, but I hear wonderful things. Beautiful white sand beaches, lots, and I mean lots of places to drink.
Well, welcome to the Florabama, which is either in Florida or Alabama. Nobody really told me which state it's in. I'm very confused about where I am. It's apparently a drink here called the Bushwhacker that'll knock you on your ass. I don't believe it, because I can drink. You've seen me drink. I can drink. This is the Bushwhacker. Famous drink they do here. Never had one before, but I've been told not to order a floater, so I ordered a floater. Let's try it. That's not bad. It's pretty good.
All right.
Tastes kind of like it tastes like a chocolate. What's in this thing?
The Florabama is an old school roadhouse, complete with license plates, live music, and inexplicable bras on the ceiling.
Strangest underwear store I've ever been to.
Sketch AF.
Yeah. Well, it looks like we are officially in Alabama now. Have not been invited to a COVID party yet, though. Waiting on that. I hear it's big here. Waiting on my first COVID party invite.
No COVID party invite, but I ended up at what can best be described as a pirate laser light show with no pirates. This was all at the Wharf, a nightlife destination with a Ferris wheel, and the Kentucky Mist Distillery, where my new friend Jack showed me how they take a bootlegger special and sell it to tourists for $28 a bottle.
Is this the stuff you serve to sorority girls on spring break to come in and they can handle whiskey, but they can't?
Now, you get that lot.
I know, Jack. Can I get all of these mixed in one cup?
I'll do anything that you want.
Then I stopped at DePour, a beer bar with 37 different taps where you can pour your own beer by the ounce. They also have a shuffle puck table. Yeah, shuffle puck is not my game. The next day, I was definitely feeling it, so I thought I'd get some fresh air out at Gulf State Park. Here, you can take their over 20 miles of bike trails, over a scenic boardwalk, under live oak trees draped in Spanish moss with magnolias and other stuff that sounds like a Blanche Devereaux story, or just relax on the beach. Me, I decided to sit in a basket and let someone else do all the work. Mostly because, you know, my feet don't really touch the pedals. It's also not unusual to see a floating tiki bar, like this one from Cruisin' Tiki's. It's a 2-hour BYOB bacchanal helmed by folks like Captain Jess. You also make all kinds of new friends, like these beautiful ladies I met from Atlanta, who were nice enough to loan me some sunglasses and teach me how to twerk. We learned we had a shared affinity for shots of Crown to the Head and, apparently, strippers. It's not all floating tiki bars and mullet tosses in Gulf Shores, though. And if you want to have a quiet, relaxing family vacation, I guess you could do that, too. I mean, if you're into that sort of thing. The beaches here are as good as any in America. And though the bushwhackers and those crazy girls on the tiki bar definitely kicked my ass this time, I will absolutely be back for round 2. I'll see you next time, Gulf Shores.